Welcome all of you. Meanwhile, I admit all the students who are joining. You may watch the video here that I am sharing with you. The thing that was watched by all of us yesterday. Would you like to watch it just for revision?
And yes, then sir.
When there will be maximum students joined here, we continue with the explanation. Purposely, I have shared the link a few minutes before so that you could get enough time to join and watch this video again.
Here is the summary of the story, Glimpses of India, A Baker from Goa, by Lucio Rodriguez. Elders of Goan community fondly remember the Portuguese rulers of Goa and their appetite for bread. The author remarks that even though the Portuguese are gone, the ones who knead, shape and bake the bread, that is the bakers, are still alive. Despite changing times, the baker or peda remained an essential figure in the Goan community. The author remembers with fondness the jingling thud of bamboo stick announcing the baker's arrival. He would pass by their house at least twice a day. He would balance the bread basket on his head with one hand while banging the bamboo stick with the other hand. As children, they used to rush out of the house and greet the baker. What they were looking for were bread bangles, a traditional Goan bread shaped like rings, which the baker sold along with loaves for the adults. The baker would greet the lady of the house. The children would then be pushed aside so that the baker could hand over the loaves to the servant. Undaunted, the children would climb up a bench to take a peep into the basket. They would not wait to brush their teeth to eat the bread. After all, there was hot tea with bread to clean up everything nicely. From a personal anecdote, the author moves on to the peda's integral role in the Goan community. Marriage gifts in the Goan community were incomplete without the traditional sweet bread known as bol. For engagements, mothers were expected to prepare sandwiches for their guests. For Christmas or other festivals, cakes and bolinhas, that is traditional coconut cookies, were essential. In the old days, bakers wore a special long frock which reached their knees. This dress was known as the kabai. The author remembers the trademark knee-length trousers worn by the baker of his childhood. Even now, if anyone wore trousers reaching to his knees, he invited the comment of being dressed like a peda. Bakers, in their glory days, also used to make a lot of money. Their plump bodies were proof of their profitable profession. The author humorously remarks that even now, anyone with a healthy appearance was still compared to a baker.
Right, you watched it? Even if we had watched it yesterday, I prefer to show you it again because some of you might not have been able to watch it and we had time. So it was a summary here that we could watch. This is 11:15 almost. I think we can start now with the text. Right, dear students?
Yes, sir.
We studied about the first text, A Baker from Goa. The question and their answers were also shared with you. You have written them, I'm sure. And you have also read the text and have listened to it. The activities given under before you read were also discussed in detail. So let's continue with directly the text here. Part 1, A Baker from Goa, from Glimpses of India. This is unit number 7 from our textbook in English for class 10, first line. So we know the title itself tells us about the baker. No? Baker, you know, dear students? Those who bake the cakes or bread and all. You know, even there is a poem in class 9. We have studied about a woman from the Northland. How she was baking cake and how great is yours. And how we have compared her with the animals. The last one that we have studied. So this is a painted portrait of a traditional Goan village baker who still has an important place in society. As per our yesterday's discussion, we know that Goa is the smallest state in India and it has been greatly influenced by the Portuguese. And this is a short, you know, painted portrait of a traditional Goan village. How the villages are there, what is the culture, how do the people live, what do they prefer, how it has been influenced by the Portuguese, that all we are going to learn in this day. Even if we have already understood everything, we'll be word by word and also try to understand the meaning between the lines here. And those bikers that time had much importance, but even today they are remembered and they have equal importance in the villages. Who? The bakers, who still has an important place in his society. So how it is and how the author describes, you know, the bakers, that's really interesting here. Our elders are often heard reminiscing nostalgically about those good old Portuguese days. The Portuguese and their famous love of loaves for bread. So L-O-A-V-E-S, what is it?
Plural of loaves.
Yes, L-O-A-F. And plural is replace F with V and suffix ES. You know about how to make singular, plural and all. So loaf and loaves, this is plural. So here the author remembers all the people that time in his childhood, those who were elder. They were talking about their past memories when the Portuguese were there in Goa. And also, they remembered those Portuguese, especially for their breads, their loaves of bread, that they were very famous among the people in the villages. Here, reminiscing nostalgically means thinking fondly of the past. You know, we forget ourselves in the present and we are lost, engrossed completely in the past. Those days, how you had enjoyed. So we become nostalgic. And that is, that quality is called nostalgia. It happens every now and then with one or the other. For example, here we are today. And after 10 years, when you will be somewhere at some higher positions and doing well with your business, if it happens that we meet, even I and you, both of us will be so nostalgic that how we had discussed about this, reminiscing nostalgically, right? So those eaters of loaves might have vanished, but the makers are still there. And those who people had those loaves, those who were very much fond of them, they might be no more today, but the people who were making that time are still there. They mean to say their next generations are there. Even the Portuguese went back, but the generations or the people, those who learned from them the way of making the loaves or breads, they are there. We still have amongst us the mixtures, the molders, and those who bake the loaves. So those people were some of them mixtures, some of them molders. You know, in India also that time there was Barabalutida system. You know that Barabalutida, that time there was no medium of currency. But simply you give one thing and in return I will either provide service,
yes, sir,
or give you something back. Farmers were providing them the grains and other people, as per their businesses, they were providing either their services or their goods that they prepare or produce, right? So that way only these three kinds of people, they had been from Portuguese. Even if they went back, but these people, they learned these qualities, these ways of their profession and are still there. So who are they? Mixtures, molders, and those who bake the loaves, means bakers. Three categories are there: mixers, molders, and bakers. Those age old, time tested furnaces still exist. And you know, the furnaces where you know they bake the cakes or the breads, they are still there. They did not take them all away because they are in use, and so they exist. The fire in the furnaces has not yet been extinguished. The third and the jingle of the traditional baker's bamboo, heralding his arrival in the morning, can still be heard in some places. Maybe the father is not alive, but the son still carries on the family profession. The bakers are even today known as bakers in Goa. And dear students, this way, here the author describes the community that the Portuguese had that time, and their professions were finally left and were passed from one generation to another in Goa. So three of them are mixers, molders, and bakers. Bakers are also known as peders in Goa. Peder is a word synonym to baker, but it is a Portuguese word, peder. And how were they doing, those bakers? They used to come in the morning, you know, by thudding and jingling the traditional baker's bamboo. Bamboo sticks were there, holding in their hands. They used to hit it on the ground, making that thud thud sound or that jingle sound. And it herald the arrival of them in the morning. And you know, it is even today, you will see some of the villages, not only in Goa, but nowadays in Maharashtra also, in villages especially, there are people who come early in the morning. Even I remember, there used to be a person who used to say loudly, Patela theva, sulivari, gya khari, khari, Patela theva, sulivari, gya khari, that way one used to call. I remember in my childhood, in my village. So this was one dialogue he used to say, but some more were there. And so people, you know, especially the children used to gather around him, and we were so happy to buy those kharis or the breads, you know. Right? What was attracting us? Not that breads. You know, we could get them from some other places also. But the way his arrival was there, once in a week or twice in a week, it was giving us the pleasure. And it, in fact, attracted us. Similarly, here also, the author is saying that the way he was, you know, the third and the jingle of the traditional baker's bamboo was announcing his arrival, and then they used to gather around him. Were they really interested in the loaves of the bread? No. Let's see what he says. And this way he says, even if those people that time are no longer here today, but their generation, his father is no more, son is there. Especially the names of the professions are also so-and-so brothers or so-and-so and sons, like that. So during our childhood in Goa, the baker used to be our friend, companion and guide. He used to come at least twice a day. Once, when he set out in the morning on his sailing round, and then again, when he returned after emptying his used basket. And while going, by emptying his baskets, that was full of loaves of breads. That time he used to come, the first. And while returning, it was the second time that he used to come across the author when he was just a small kid. And that way, he found that seller of the breads, we can say a baker or a peder, was their friend, companion, and also guide. How he was friend, how he was companion, and how he was guide? Let's see. Once, when he set out in the morning on his selling round, and then again, when he returned after emptying his new basket, the jingling thud of his bamboo woke us up from sleep, and we ran to meet and greet him. Why was it so? Was it for the love of the loaf? Not at all. The loaves were bought by some baskin or bastin, the maid servant of the house. What we longed for were those bread bangles, which we chose carefully. Sometimes it was sweet bread of special make. And you know, dear students, it was in fact their love for the loaf, but especially those bangles, bread bangles. You know what are the bread bangles? I think they are known with some other name in Maharashtra, in Hindi also. You can see here, I am sharing with you. Can you see these Bengal breads. In fact, they are known as kankon in Kokni language, but it literally translates in English as bangle because they are in the shape of bangle, and it is a distinctive ring-shaped bread that is popular all over Goa. Can you see your students here on your screen?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Very good.
Yes,
very
good. Sir.
And you know, they wanted to choose because some of them especially and sometimes they were little sweet bread of some special make. They might be in different in colors, or they might be little sweet than the others, and that way they wanted to choose them. Of course, the baker was not giving those bread bangles and also the loaves of bread to the children because there were some maids, those who could buy for the children, and they were known at that time Baskin or Bastin. And this way, you know, you can imagine how that baker comes hurrying and singling his bamboo stick, and children are getting up, hearing that sound without making any excuses to get up or wake up, and without even brushing their teeth, they are gathering around him, just getting out of their beds, and they are there. I want this, I want that, and that way they are making the fuss and noise around. Then what did the baker do? And what about those maids? Let's see. The baker made his musical. So are you getting why the author has mentioned that a baker was a friend, companion, and guide for them?
Yes, sir.
Good. So even I remember in my childhood, I used to get up at 4 o'clock. And was going from one house to another, that of my friends, and used to ask them to get up so that we could go for a walk for almost 1.5 or 2 or more than, not more than 3 kilometers, but that much of distance we used to walk, getting up at 4 o'clock. Sometimes it was my duty to get them all up. Sometimes it was their duty to get up all of us. Sometimes we used to sleep together also at one of our friends' place. And that way, you know, being together gives us pleasure also, and we do the thing happily rather than being alone at home and parents are asking you to get up and you say, no, I don't want, I want to sleep, right? So this way he was a guide, a companion, and a friend for or the author when he was just a small kid. Then the baker made his musical entry on the scene with the thang thang sound of specially made bamboo staff. One hand supported the basket on his head and the other banged in the bamboo on the ground. You know, bamboo one on one hand and another hand holding the basket on his head. On his head only, na? Yes. Because in some of videos I'll show you, you will find that he has hold it on the basket or just holding back, carrying a bamboo stick on his shoulder. But here what is given, that that basket is on his head and other hand is just banging the bamboo on the ground. He would greet the lady of the house with good morning and then place his basket on the vertical bamboo. And then that bamboo used to be held as a support to the basket. And that way with both of hands, he used to get the one that they chose and was handing them over to those maids or maid servants like Paskin or Baskin, and those ladies whom he used to greet in the morning, good morning. Wickets would be pushed aside with a mild rebuke and the loaves would be delivered to the servant. And if the children are there around, there used to be, you know, little rebuke, an expression of disapproval. Hey, you please move out. You don't touch it. Which one you want, you just point it out. And you know how do the people do, especially with the children. They're not allowed. And their breads and the loaves of breads or the bread bangles were finally handed to the servants. But we would not give up. But the children can't be called the children or the kids if they are just standing there quiet. How can they? They are finding some other ways to peep into the basket and asking him to give that and another or what, whatever or whichever they want. So what trick or the way used to they follow? Let's see. We would climb a bench or the parapet and peep into the basket somehow. I can still recall the typical fragrance of those loaves for the elders and the bangles for the children. And you know, finally, He remembers, the author still remembers, the way they used to stand on the parapet or the benches nearby and were trying to peep into the basket so that they could choose the best one that they want. And even the smell, that fragrance of the herbs, the fresh one, was really attracting them, and so they were very much fond of those breads. But the breads, those loaves of the breads were for the elders, and the bread bangle were for the children. And accordingly, every day, you know, these people from Goa could enjoy, and even today, they must be enjoying these breads. Then we did not even care to brush our teeth or wash our mouths properly. And you know, they did not have much time, because simply getting up from the bed, they were running out to meet their friend, the baker. And they are gathering around him, choosing the best bread bangle they want. How could they wait? They did not want to waste their time in brushing their teeth. And they used to start with that. How? Let's see. And what excuse does he find, saying that he was not interested in brushing? What are the other alternatives? Then we did not care to brush our teeth or wash our mouths properly. And why should we? Who would take the trouble of plucking the mango leaf for the toothbrush? And you know, that time, not the brush, not the toothpaste were there, but they had to simply pluck the mango leaf and brush the teeth like a toothbrush. Even neem stick is also used nowadays. Even the leaves of the neem tree or the basil are also used. Even the ash that is there left after the wood is burned is also used, you know, to brush the teeth. And why was it necessary at all? He asked. Was it the need to clean the mouth or brush the teeth? No, he finds one reason here. The tiger never brushes teeth. Hot tea could wash and clean up everything so nicely. After all, and here he says, that the tiger never brushes his teeth, but see the teeth they have, the tigers. And one more reason he finds, that hot tea, so hot with, you know, the braids and braid bangles, easily wash everything and clean up the mouth after all so nicely. Here the author says. Dear students, here again I'm going to play a video so that you can understand this well, and I'm sure you have already understood thinking about the situation and the scenario they are in.
Yes, yes.
Goa. Okay? But just for more better understanding, I'm playing one more video here. Would you like to watch so that we can discuss the question and answers also? And
yes,
here
sir.
Also,
yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
You will find some answers. It's a little funny, right? Here it is.
I would like to tell the parents, the kids who cannot sit at one place, they should take up coding.
Glimpses of India Part 2. Korg. Korg, or Kudag, is the smallest district of Karnataka. It's famous for its coffee, rainforests and spices. Midway between Mysore and Mangalore sits the Korg that must have been carried from the kingdom of God. of India, Part 1. A baker, from Goa. As the name indicates, 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 the name indicates. If you have not subscribed yet, please subscribe, and join our small family. Elder people of Goa are often thinking about the past, about those old Portuguese days, and their loaves of bread. Those eaters of loaves might have gone, but the makers still exist. The fire in the furnaces has not extinguished. Means that the furnaces on which breads were baked by those Portuguese have not came to an end. The bakers may have died, but the sons still carry the family profession. These bakers are known as potter.
Remember, the bakers of Goa are known as potter.
Now tell me, what are the elders in Goa nostalgic about? Nostalgic means memories of past. The answer is,
the elders are nostalgic about the old Portuguese days, the Portuguese, and their famous loaves of bread in Goa.
Don't be happy. Tell one more answer. Is bread making still popular in Goa? How do you know? The answer is,
the bread baking is a tradition in Goa. The bakers may have died, but the sons still carry on this occupation. Thus, bread making is still popular in Goa.
During our childhood, the baker came at least twice a day. Once, in the morning, to sell his loaves and breads, and again returning, with his basket empty. And the thing to be surprised is that, he had two hands. No, he had two hands. One hand to support his basket on the head, and the other hit the bamboo on the ground to make a jang jang sound. He sold two things: the famous loaves and the bread bangles. We didn't buy the loaves, they were bought by the maidservant. But we loved the bread bangles, which we chose carefully. Then we didn't even care to brush our teeth or wash mouths properly. And why should we? Who would take the trouble of plucking the mango leaf for the toothbrush? And why is it necessary at all? The tiger never brushed his teeth. Hot tea could wash and clean up everything so nicely. After all, remember, baker would come twice a day at the morning for selling, and again for returning. The children ran to meet him, because they longed for the bread bangles. Marriage gifts are meaningless without the sweet bread known as ball.
Yes, dear students, it was just a summary that I wanted to show you through this video. I hope you have understood it, this part.
Yes, sir.
Any doubt? I'm just scrolling up.
No, sir.
Page number 87 and 88. Any doubt? A baker from Goa. How those memories are there, you know, like reminiscing nostalgically. Then what is it about? What was that sound of? Who are the bakers? Who are the two more professionals there, like bakers? They were mixers and also molders. Then at what time the baker used to come in his village? How was he their friend and also companion and guide? Who loved the loaves of bread and who wanted the bread bangles? Also, what was the sound that was made by the whom did the baker give this bread and the loaves of bread and also the bread bangle? You got all of these answers, understood well? How the children gather around and try to peep into it? And did the children brush? If yes, how? If not, why didn't they wish to brush their teeth? Right? So these are the questions I have asked you. I'm sure if you have understood the answers of the questions, we can proceed with the next. But it is a minute only left with us. No, 6 minutes are there. Meanwhile, can we discuss this oral comprehension check question?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So the first question here is, Gauri, can you read? And Gauri Paragavkar, you read and try to answer.
Question number 1. What are the elders in Goa nostalgic about? So may I answer?
Yes, dear, please.
The elders in the Goa are nostalgic about the bread bangles which they used, which the Portuguese actually brought, but this tradition went on.
Very good. Dori Santare, would you like to answer? What are the elders in Goa nostalgic about? No? She's saying something, but we are not getting it. Anyway, Gauri, I'm telling answer here that the narrator often finds his elders telling him about things about old days, telling them about the famous bread that date back to the time when Portuguese ruled over India. They ponder over the past and tell them that though the Portuguese have left Goa, but the bakers still exist. If not the original one, their legacy is being continued by their sons. Right? Now the second question. Grover, would you like to read it and answer the second question? Okay, push it on, you can.
Is bread making still popular in Goa? How do you know?
Both you, please answer.
Yes, bread making is still popular in Goa. Because even the Portuguese have left, but their legacy has been continued by their following generations, and still people are fond of the Portuguese loaves.
Very good. So yes, bread making is still popular in the city of Goa, even in the villages. It is evident from the existence of time-tested furnaces that they are there, and even the mixers and molders, besides the bakers. The legacy of bakers is being continued by their sons. You will find a bakery in every Goan village, as bread is an important part of the Goan culture. So yes, they are there even today, right? The third question here is, you can see, what is the baker called? And I would like here Devika Khandelwal to answer it. Devika, can you hear? Prisha. Prisha Bajaj, are you attentive or just you are here through the mobile phone, but mobile phone is kept aside and you are somewhere? Ishwari,
we are here.
Very good. Ishwari, can you answer here?
What is the, yes, sir. What is the baker called? The baker is even known as Pedar in Goa.
Yes, it is a synonym to baker, a Portuguese word. What is it? Baker. And then the next question here, I would like Harshavardhan Maki to read, number 4.
When would the baker come every day? Why did the children run to meet him?
Can you answer? When would the baker come every day? Yes, dear Harshvardhan.
Yes, sir.
Can you please answer?
Sir, I have not actually got it. So I will just make it and tell you.
All right. Don't worry. Here is Meet to answer. Meet, can you answer here? Meet Patel. Nikita Mashe. Prathamesh Garar, Sakshi Hoshing, Janvi Bhatia, anybody? Anyone, my dear school?
Sir, can I tell?
Here is Prathamesh. Very good, dear. You can answer it.
Sir, the baker came twice every day in the morning, and once he went out in the morning on selling round, and then again when would he return after emptying his huge basket? The children ran to meet him.
Another part. Why did the children run to meet him?
Because they were fond of that bread bangle. That's why they used to run to him.
Very good. They wanted to take the special bread bangle. You know, he used to prepare sometimes, not all the time. And so they used to run after in search of the special breads, right? Anybody will answer it completely now to both the parts of the question?
May I answer, sir?
Yes, Sakshi, you can. Immediately, dear. Don't take much time. This is 11:45. Okay, I'll answer. The baker would come twice every day during the narrative's childhood days. Once in the morning to deliver the loaves of bread, and secondly in the evening on his return after selling his stock. The children would go running to him to take the special bread bangles he had made for them. So if it is evening time, I think we have not got any reference in the text, but there are chances that he might be selling those breads throughout the day and might be coming back in the evening, or it may also happen that just selling those breads in 1 or 2 hours in the morning itself, he was coming back. So don't mention especially if it is noon time or evening time, but do mention that he was going the first time in the morning and was returning on the same way back, emptying his basket. Right, yes, sir. Any doubt? Any query?
No, sir.
All right then. That's it.
No, sir.
Thank you so much. Take care. Have a nice time. Bye.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Bye.
Bye, sir.
Bye, sir.
Thank you, sir. Bye, sir.